We're here in Kalusapang in Bengkulu, and I'm standing on the ramp of an evacuation building, a tsunami evacuation building. The village here is on low-lying ground, and the coast is only less than a kilometer that way, and there's no high relief to run to. So this is why this is an initiative of the local city to build this structure here and develop some community awareness of the hazard. The building is about 16 meters tall, and historically they've had tsunamis here to about 8 meters, so it should be enough height for people to evacuate in the event of a tsunami or a warning. It takes 2,000 people. It's going to be used as a village centre in the meantime. And on the fourth floor it has toilet facilities and kitchen facilities for cooking. The tsunami building is designed to have a ramp here for disabled and elderly people. And it's also wide stairs, which allows people to get up very quickly. The building's been constructed with round columns. The round columns are for allowing debris to pass around without damaging the corners of the columns, and the openness is for allowing debris and water to flow through it in the event of a tsunami. It is built to good earthquake code. So firstly, it's got to survive the earthquake, and then people will come here and evacuate to the fourth floor. Okay, we've travelled here to Pesisir Selatan in West Sumatra, and you can see the sea down there, and this whole area of the main town here is subject to tsunamis. And I'm standing on a different kind of tsunami shelter than we saw the other day. It's been provided by nature, but it's been modified to provide a tsunami evacuation area. Its capacity is about 5,000 people, and in that blue building down there is where all the logistical supplies are, the food, the water that's needed after an evacuation.